It's been a while since I put up a history video on this channel, and seeing how the last one did extremely well, which warrants another video of the same nature, I would like to thank you all for over 8,000 views on that video and for over 300 subscribers. Today, I will be talking about a unique SD45 equipped with a 3,800 horsepower Caterpillar engine, that unit being the one and only 6,000. Don't look back. 1965 saw the introduction of the EMD SD45. This unit was the newest in Electromotive's Special Duty series. Equipped with the EMD 645 E3 Prime Mover, a 20-cylinder, 3,600 horsepower, turbocharged, two-stroke engine, which had been introduced that year as a replacement for the venerable but aging EMD 567, which had reached its limits in the horsepower category. The traction motors on the SD45 were of the D77 model, and the unit was equipped with six of them. Seeing that these were the first EMD units to roll out with the new, massive, 20-cylinder, 3,600 horsepower, 645 E3 Prime movers, problems were plenty and pretty much inevitable from the very start. Units would suffer from blown crankshafts as a result of the length of the crankshaft itself, as well as from the engine block flexing. Other problems could be found in the engine block itself, as it was found that cracks would form around the seals. To prevent the blown crankshaft issue, some roads decided to downrate their SD45s to only produce 3,200 horsepower in order to lighten the strain on the crankshafts and prevent failures. In July of 1968, EMD was finishing up the last SD45s for the Pennsylvania Railroad. These units were equipped with dynamic brakes for service on the PRR. One of these engines was SD45 number 6224. And was one of the last new units that the Pennsy received. The unit was painted up in the PRR black freight scheme and was pressed into freight service after delivery.
6224 would wear one horn and one horn only, a Leslie S3L. Here's a sample.
In the early part of May 1979, the unit was finally repainted from the Penn Central Black into Conrail's iconic blue paint scheme. On the 7th of February 1983, the unit was sold off to the Chicago Northwestern, one of the numerous SD45s that came to the Northwestern during their massive SD45 buying spree of the 1980s. The unit was renumbered 6547 and would be placed into freight service on the CNW shortly after arriving. That is, until 1986 rolled around. Almost exactly 3 years later, in the very early part of 1986, Chicago Northwestern shops at Olean, Iowa, shopped the 6547 and rebuilt it into the only SD Cat that the road rostered. Now, you may be thinking to yourself, what is this SD Cat? Well, the SD Cat was an SD45 replaced with a 12-cylinder twin-turbocharged Caterpillar 3612, which was rated at 3,800 horsepower. This engine replaced the original 645 E3 and the 6547 that dated back to the unit's construction in 1968. Even though the Cat engine was rated for 3,800 horsepower, the 3612 was downrated to 3,000 horsepower due to the limitations and problems associated with the existing EMD AR10B alternator. The 6000 was equipped with a high-pressure air starter system for starting the massive 4-stroke 3612. The idea itself was a good one, seeing the problems associated with the 20-cylinder 645 E3 as described earlier in the video. However, due to the limitations of the AR-10B, the SD Cat suffered as a result of this problem. Also, the unit was extremely heavy as a result of the addition of the new Cat 3612, coming in at 410,300 pounds, whereas a stock SD45 weighed in at 368,000 pounds. Not really a surprise, seeing that the existing 20-cylinder 645E3 weighed 4,148 pounds, while the new Cat 3612 weighed a hefty 55,300 pounds, a 15,156 pound difference. Now, it must be noted that this unit sounded unique. Well, any cat-powered unit sounds unique. Crews are thrown off by this unit due to the fact that it didn't rev up like a normal SD45 equipped with a 20-cylinder EMD 645E3. One CNW engineer who, quote, operated EMD power 99.99% of the time, operated the 6000 and had this to say: it sounded good, but the sound was strange. It didn't rev up or down the same way an EMD did. The sound threw me off only a tiny bit, but just enough to make me notice. Another said that the sound could be described as a sort of throaty rumble or growl sound, like a very big bulldozer. It was also said that the unit had a nasty buzzy vibration that permeated the seats when in run 8 throttle. On the 3rd of February 1986, the freshly shopped 6000 exited the Chicago Northwestern shops at Olean, Iowa, and was returned to freight service on the Northwestern. 4 years later, in February of 1990, the 6000 was pulled from service and was subsequently stored. The Northwestern made this decision, citing issues with the new Cat 3612 and EMD AR-10B alternator pairing that had plagued the unit with issues since the very start. The other big problem was the hefty weight of the unit, which was another thing that plagued the unit's operation. The unit, some way or another, made its way to GE Erie in 1993, for some reason, not quite sure why the unit was actually there, but it still happened nonetheless. However, after the UP merger of 1996, the Union Pacific sold the unit to Helm Leasing, seeing the problems that have been associated with the unit in its time on the Chicago Northwestern. Helm rebuilt this unit into the prototype for the SD45-3. They removed the Cat 3612 and replaced it with an EMD 3500 horsepower, 16-cylinder, 645E3B prime mover. The unit, now numbered 6600, still serves for Helm Leasing. However, the unit now greatly differs from her days in freight service on the Chicago Northwestern. To round out another episode on one of the most interesting units on the Chicago Northwestern roster, to round out another episode on some interesting equipment, I just want to say that this won't be the last video of this type. There is more unique motive power to cover, and another SD Cat. However, if you enjoyed this video, please make sure to like and subscribe. If you want more of these types of videos, please feel free to drop a comment below, if you please. Yeah. I'm CNW Productions. Thank you for watching.